So first of all, I welcome you all to my fourth video on the chapter that is coordination compounds. In the previous video, we discussed something about nomenclature of complexes. It's based on the guidelines given by the IUPAC system of nomenclature. We named different types of complexes. So that is the discussion that we had in the previous video. In the today's video, you know, we'll discuss something about isomerism in complexes. One more important phenomenon that we observe in the case of complexes. You are very much familiar with the phenomenon isomerism in organic compounds, where you studied isomerism as the phenomenon in which two or more compounds have same molecular formula, but they differ in their physical and chemical properties. The phenomenon is called as isomerism, and the compounds are called as isomers. Here also in complexes, coordination compounds, we define isomerism as the phenomenon in which two or more compounds have same molecular formula, but they differ in their physical and chemical properties due to the difference in arrangement of atoms or groups around the central metal ion or atom in a given complex, and that is what we call it as isomerism. The phenomenon in which two or more compounds have same molecular formula, but they differ in physical and chemical properties due to the difference in arrangement of atoms or groups around the central metal atom or ion in a complex compound, and that is what we call isomerism. And the compounds are called as isomers, is it not? In complexes also, we have two types of isomerism. One, it will be structural isomerism. One, it will be structural isomerism. Another is stereoisomerism. Here also we have two types of isomerism, structural isomerism and stereoisomerism. And once again, in the case of structural isomerism, two or more coordination compounds have got same molecular formula, but they have different structural arrangement of atoms or groups around the central metal atom. Two or more compounds are characterized by same molecular formula, but they differ in the bonds between central metal ion and ligands. They differ in bonds between central metal ion and ligands, even though they have same molecular formula. So that is what we call it as structural isomerism. And you know, as far as isomers are concerned, they differ in their physical and chemical properties. And in structural isomerism, the difference in physical and chemical properties of isomers is due to the difference in structural arrangement of the atoms or groups around the central metal atom or ion. So that is what we call it as structural isomerism. And in structural isomerism, here we have different types. One, it will be ionization isomerism. One, it will be ionization isomerism. Second, it will be linkage isomerism. Third, it will be coordination isomerism. Fourth, it will be hydrate isomerism. These are the four types of structural isomerism that we come across in coordination compounds. Let me repeat. Structural isomerism will be of four types: ionization isomerism, linkage isomerism, coordination isomerism, and hydrate isomerism. We'll see one by one in detail. As far as ionization isomerism, in a single sentence, what I can say that this is structural isomerism due to the difference in ionization behavior of coordination compounds in water. This is structural isomerism due to the difference in ionization behavior of complexes in water. So that is what we call it as ionization isomerism. Or I can say the phenomenon in which two or more complexes have same molecular formula, but They produce different ions on ionization in water. Two or more complexes have got same molecular formula, but they produce different ions on ionization in water. So that is what we call it as ionization isomerism. And as far as example for the ionization isomerism is concerned, let me give one example that
CO NS3 5 times Br.
And of course, SO4, this is one complex. I just name this complex as
pentamine bromido cobalt 3 sulfate.
Okay, this is name of the complex. And this complex is dissolved in water. It undergoes ionization to form CO NS3 5 times. And of course Br, and of course 2 plus, then it is SO4 2 minus. This is how this complex undergoes ionization. Okay, now that is the solution of this complex contains sulfate ions. You know that whatever we have written inside the square bracket, inside the coordination sphere, will not be further ionized. And this is ionization of this complex, and its ionization isomer is CO NS3 5 times SO4. Yes, CO NS3 5 times SO4, and of course Br. This is ionization isomer of this complex. As far as name of this complex is concerned, pentamine sulfato cobalt 3 bromide. Pentamine sulfato cobalt 3 bromide. This is cobalt, CO, yes, capital C, small O. And it should be clearly written, capital C, small O. And if it undergoes ionization in water, it produces, look at this, it produces the complex ion CO NS3 5 times, and of course SO4. And of course it will be, yes it is plus, then it will be, yes it is Br minus. The solution of this complex contains bromine ions, solution of this complex contains sulfate ions. Therefore, these two complexes have got same molecular formula. In spite of that, they are going to produce different types of ions. Such type of isomerism is called ionization isomerism. Isomerism in which two or more compounds have got same molecular formula. Look at the molecular formula of both the compounds will be same. Not it will be Br either, it will be Br either. It will sulfate either, it will sulfate either. And they are going to produce different types of ions. One isomer can be converted into another isomer just by interchanging the ions between coordination sphere and ionic sphere. This is coordination sphere, this is ionization sphere. I am going to exchange sulfate with bromide in order to produce this isomer. So this is ionization isomers can be obtained by interchanging the ions between coordination sphere and ionization sphere. So this is what we call it as the ionization isomerism. And if there is any question, write examples for the ionization isomerism. You must write the, yes it is the pair of these two compounds. Yes. Yes, and let me remind you once again, and as far as ionization of complexes is concerned, whatever we written outside the square bracket will be ionized, but not the things which are written inside the square bracket. Sulfate is in the outside the square bracket, that's why it is ionized. Bromide is outside the square bracket, that's why it is ionized. Okay, so this is what we call ionization isomerism. Now let me see that second type of, yes it is structural isomerism, that will be linkage isomerism there. This linkage isomerism is observed in the case of complexes with ambident ligands. Complexes containing ambident ligands will show this linkage isomerism. Here this is the isomerism, this is the structural isomerism, due to the difference in mode of attachment of ligands with the central metal ion. Two or more compounds differ one another with respect to their mode of attachment of ligands with central metal ion, and that is due to the presence of ambivalent ligands. That's why, you know, linkage isomerism can be defined as the structural isomerism in which two or more compounds have got same molecular formula, but they differ in their mode of attachment of ligands with central metal ion. But they differ in mode of attachment of ligands with central metal ion. So that is what we call it as linkage isomerism. And as far as examples are concerned, look at this CO, NH3 5 times, NO2, this is what we call it as Cl2, this is one of the complexes. Just observe here, NO2 there, this is ambivalent ligand, is it not? And it is linkage isomer of, yes it is, linkage isomer of CO, NH3 5 times, ONO there, this is ONO, and of course it will be Cl2 there. Just observe here the difference between these two. Both have got same molecular formula. Molecular formula is same, but the difference is in this case that nitro group, NO2 group, is attached to the cobalt through nitrogen. In this case, in this complex, nitro group, NO2 group, is attached to the central metal ion. Yes, it is cobalt 3 plus. Yes, it is. NO2 group is attached to the cobalt ion, that is CO3 plus, through nitrogen. This is the arrangement in the case of this complex. In this complex, look at this. This NO2 group is attached to the cobalt 3 plus ion. In this case, NO2 group is attached to the cobalt 3 plus ion through oxygen. And that's why I said two complexes differ in their mode of attachment with the central metal ion. Here, NO2 group, ambivalent ligand, is attached to the cobalt ion through nitrogen. Here, the ambivalent ligand is attached to the central metal ion through oxygen. That's the difference. Because of that, you know, there is a difference in their physical and chemical properties. One of the properties I can tell you there, this complex is yellow in color. This complex is yellow in color, but this complex is red in color. That's the difference in physical properties. So this is what we call it as linkage isomerism. These two are the examples for linkage isomerism. So this is one more type of structural isomerism. Apart from that, you know, we have coordination isomerism. One more type of, yes, it is structural isomerism, that is coordination isomerism. This type of isomerism is found in binuclear complexes. This type of isomerism is found in binuclear complexes. Binuclear complexes are the complexes which will be characterized by two coordination entities. In the previous video, I already gave some examples for the binuclear complexes. For example, this is CO, and of course NH3 6 times. This is one coordination entity. And this is Cr, Cn 6 times. This is another coordination entity. This complex is characterized by two coordination entities. That's why it is binuclear complex. Now then, coordination isomerism is found in binuclear complexes. And this coordination isomerism arises due to the exchange of ligands between cationic and anionic entities of the complex. This type of isomerism arises due to the exchange of ligands between cationic and anionic entities of different metal ions present in binuclear complex. This is one isomer. If you want to write the coordination isomer of this complex, simply you exchange the ligands between two different metal ions. Look at this. In this case, cobalt is attached to the ammonia molecules. And if I exchange this ammonia molecule with chromium, then it will be chromium. Then it is NH3 6 times. So then it is cobalt and it is CN6. Just observe. There is an interchange of ligands between coordination entities of different metal ions in binuclear complex. And that is what we call it as coordination isomerism. This is cationic part. This is anionic part. Atwa this is cationic coordination entity. This is anionic coordination entity. Just by interchanging ligands between cationic and anionic coordination entities of different metal ions in binuclear complexes, and that is you can get different types of coordination isomers. So this is what we call it as, these two are the examples for, yes, it is coordination isomerism. In this case, ammonia molecules are attached to the cobalt here. Cyano groups are attached to the chromium here. But here, ammonia is attached to the chromium, cyano is attached to the, yes, it is cobalt there. That's the difference there. So this is what we call it as coordination isomerism. A type of structural isomerism arises due to the interchange of ligands between cationic and anionic entities of the different metal ions in given binuclear complex. That is what we call it as coordination isomerism. Okay? And let us see that one more type of structural isomerism. As per your NCERT textbook, it will be hydrate isomerism. As the name itself indicates, hydrate, and it refers to the water, yes. This is a kind of isomerism due to the difference in number of water molecules among the isomers of the compound. That's why it is hydrate isomerism. The structural isomerism in which two or more compounds have got same molecular formula, but they differ in number of water molecules. They differ in number of water molecules as ligands or as molecules of hydration. Because you know, water can behave like a, yes, it is ligand, or it, water can participate in the formation of hydrates. And because of that, you know, this type of isomerism is observed in the case of complexes where two or more complexes have got same molecular formula, but they differ in number of water molecules as ligands or as molecules of hydration. So that is what we call it as hydrate isomerism. For example, if I take this, yes, it is Cr, H2O 6 times Cl3, this is one complex. Hexa aqua chromium 3 chloride, yes, this is one complex. Okay? And if I interchange water molecules between coordination sphere and ionization sphere, you are going to get hydrate isomers. Just interchange one water molecule with one chloride group, then you are going to get, yes, it is Cr H2O, yes, one water molecule is shifted to ionization sphere, then number of water molecules will remain as 5, and one chloride group will enter into the coordination sphere, and it is Cl there, and of course it will be Cl2, one chloride group is entering into the coordination sphere, Cl2 we have dot H2O there. This is what we call it as hydrate isomers, and these two are hydrate isomers because in this case there are 6 water molecules. They are acting like ligands. But in this case, 5 water molecules are acting like ligands. In this case, no water molecules are there as molecules of hydration. But here, one molecule is there as molecule of hydration. That's why I said, two or more compounds have got same molecular formula, but they differ in number of water molecules as ligands and as molecules of hydration. That is what we call it as hydrate isomerism. And of course, actually, this complex is violet in color. This complex is gray-green colored substance, that is. Gray-green colored substance. This is what we call it as the difference in their physical properties. So, this is what we call it as structural isomerism as far as coordination compounds are concerned. And of course, very important discussion as far as your annual examination is concerned. You can expect a 2-mark question on any one of these 4 types of isomerism. So this is what we call it as structural isomerism. Now at this moment, we'll go to the one more kind of isomerism that we observe in the case of, yes, it is coordination compounds, and that will be stereoisomerism, right? Now let us see one more type of isomerism as far as coordination compounds are concerned. That is what we call stereoisomerism. And of course, you are very much familiar with this particular concept in organic chemistry. You studied this in the chapter haloalkanes and halorings. Stereoisomerism is a phenomenon in which 2 or more compounds have got same molecular formula as well as structural formula. In the case of stereoisomerism, molecular formula and the structural formula of compounds will be same. Even then, they show difference in their physical and chemical properties. Even though the molecular formula and structural formula is same, they exhibit difference in their physical and chemical properties. And that is due to the difference in arrangement of atoms or groups around the center metal ion in space. That means stereoisomers have got different spatial arrangement of atoms or groups around the central metal atom or ion, and that phenomenon is called as stereoisomerism. Or you can say the isomers which have different spatial arrangement of atoms or groups around the central atom or around the central atom or ion, and that is what we call it as stereoisomerism. Stereoisomerism will be of 2 types. One, it will be geometrical isomerism, or it will be geometrical isomerism. Another, it will be optical isomerism. Same type as you studied in organic chemistry. There also you studied geometrical isomerism or cis-trans isomerism. So also we have optical isomerism. Look at this. What is this geometrical isomerism? Geometrical isomerism is stereoisomerism, where 2 or more compounds have got different geometrical arrangement of atoms or groups around the central metal atom or ion. Geometrical isomerism is stereoisomerism, in which 2 or more compounds have different geometrical arrangement of atoms or groups around the central metal ion. So that is what we call it as geometrical isomerism. And I said this is also known as cis-trans isomerism. There are 2 possible geometrical arrangements in the case of geometrical isomers. Because of that, there are 2 types of geometrical isomers. One, it will be, yes, it is cis isomers, and another will be trans isomers. One, it will be cis isomers, another it will be trans isomers. As you know that in the case of cis isomers, similar atoms or groups occupy the positions which are adjacent to each other, or in the case of cis isomers, 2 similar groups are on the same side, whereas in the case of trans isomers, similar groups or atoms occupy the positions which are opposite to each other. Yes, in the case of trans isomers, 2 similar groups or atoms occupy the positions which are opposite to each other. That is what we call trans isomers. Atva, in trans isomers, 2 similar groups are on the opposite sides. In the case of cis isomers, 2 similar groups are on the same side. So this is what we call it as cis and trans isomers. And that is types of geometrical isomerism. And as far as your NCERT textbook is concerned, you are supposed to study, that is, geometrical isomerism in the case of complexes with a coordination number 4 and coordination number 6. So we'll see one by one. Geometrical isomerism in complexes with coordination number 4 there. Yes. Geometrical isomerism in complexes, that is complexes with coordination number 4. As you know that for a coordination number 4, there are two possible, yes, it is geometrical arrangements. Tetrahedral complexes. In the case of tetrahedral complexes, we have coordination number 4 there, central coordination number of central midline is 4. One more type of complexes will be, yes, it is square planar complexes. In tetrahedral and square planar complexes, you know, the coordination number of central midline will be 4. We'll see geometrical isomerism in tetrahedral complexes and square planar complexes first. As you know that in the case of tetrahedral complexes, look at this, central metal atom is attached to the ligands in tetrahedral fashion. Yes, so for example, this is A, this is B, this is C, this is D. Look at this, this is tetrahedral complex. In the case of tetrahedral complexes attached with different unidentate ligands, geometrical isomerism not possible. Why it is so? Geometrical isomerism not possible in tetrahedral complexes because in the case of tetrahedral complexes, the relative positions of the ligands attached to the central metal ion are same with respect to each other. In the case of tetrahedral complexes, the relative positions of the ligands attached to the central metal ion are same with respect to each other. Because of that, you cannot get different possible spatial arrangements for tetrahedral complexes because of their arrangement in their molecules, and therefore geometrical isomerism not possible in the case of tetrahedral complexes. Whereas in the case of square planar complexes, that geometrical isomerism is possible. In the case of square planar complexes, geometrical isomerism is possible, and that too, that is, heteroleptic square planar complexes will exhibit geometrical isomerism. Now the heteroleptic complexes are complexes where different ligands are attached to the central metal ion. For example, the complexes of the type MA2B2, this is a complex where A is a unidentate ligand, B is a unidentate ligand. Four ligands are there, other, and of course, in this case, four ligands can be arranged around the central atom like this. This is A, this is A, this is B, this is B. Look at this. This is square planar complex where two similar groups are on the same side, or you can say two similar atoms or groups occupy the positions which are adjacent to each other. Other. Two similar groups occupy the positions adjacent to each other, is it not? So that is what we call it as, this is cis isomer. This is cis isomer. Whereas in the case of trans isomer, look at this. Two similar groups occupy the positions which are opposite to each other. Yes, look at this. This is what we call it as the one more geometrical arrangement for, yes, it is MA2B2 type complex, and this is what we call it as, yes, it is trans isomer. This is cis isomer and it will be trans isomer. And of course, this type of geometrical isomerism in square planar complexes is possible if there is a complex of the type MA2B2. And if the complex is of the type MA4, MBA3 or MB3A, look at this. These are also the square planar complexes. In this case, if all the ligands are same, A, B or what? Ligands. If all the ligands are same, then no different geometrical arrangements possible for the complex. Therefore, no geometrical isomerism. In these complexes, no geometrical isomerism because different spatial arrangements are not possible for these particular molecules. That's why they do not exhibit geometrical isomerism. But here, complexes of the type MA2B2 will show that, yes, it is geometrical isomerism. This is cis isomer, this is trans isomer. And of course, as far as square planar complexes are concerned, we have a complex of the type, yes, M, A, B, C, D. M is a central metal atom. A, B, C, D are ligands. All the ligands are different. Does it exhibit geometric isomerism? Definitely. This complex will exhibit geometric isomerism. We'll see that. Yes, it is. This is M. And it is attached to the four groups A, B, C and D. This is a square planar complex where central metal atom is attached to the four different groups. And that is they are arranged in, yes, it is square planar fashion. How many geometric isomers are possible for this complex? For this complex, you know, three geometric isomers are possible. Out of three, two are cis isomers, one is trans isomer. Noting. For this particular complex, you know, three geometric isomers are possible. Out of three, two are cis isomers and one is trans isomer. And in order to write the geometric isomers for this complex, you fix the position of one of the ligands, A. You fix the position of any one of the ligands. Let me fix the position of A. With respect to A and B are cis to each other. With respect to this A, position A, that is B and A are cis. Yes, it is. They are cis to each other. Therefore, it is cis isomer. A and B are on the same side. Therefore, it is cis isomer. And now at this moment, you change the position of ligand. You change the position of ligands by fixing position of A. Don't change the position of A. You change the position of other ligands. You change the position of B. Now B is here. D is here. C is here. And this is one more possible arrangement. Yes. With respect to A, B is trans to each other. A and B are trans to each other. Here A and B are cis to each other. Therefore it is called as, yes, it is trans isomer. And apart from that, you know, I can write one more geometric isomer for this complex. Look at this. Without changing the position of A there. If A position change maadabadu. Yes. You change the position of B. Now I can bring B here. And of course C here. And of course D here. Yes. Look at this. Look at this position. Yes, it is in this position. A and B are cis to each other. In this particular arrangement, A and B are cis to each other. Therefore, it is cis isomer. That's why I said in the case of square complexes of the type M, A, B, C, D, where central metal atom is attached to four different groups. And in that case, you know, there are three geometric isomers possible. One is a trans isomer and remaining two will be cis. And I had shown how to write the geometric isomers for this complex. So this is what we call geometric isomerism in square planar complex. And as an example for this, you know, you are supposed to write geometric isomers of one complex, platinum complex, yes. And that will be, yes, it is geometrical isomerism in platinum. Yes, it is NS3 two times Cl2 there. This is one complex diamine dichloride platinum 2. Yes. And platinum is a central metal atom. Yes. Look at this. Platinum is attached with, yes, it is four ligands. If two similar ligands are on the same side, look at this. Whenever you are writing the structures of the complexes, you just observe ligand will be attached to the central metal atom through donor atom. Ligand should be attached to the central metal atom through donor atoms. Nitrogen is a donor atom. Your nitrogen is a donor atom. Yes, this is what we call it as. Yes, it is cis isomer. So we call it as cis platin. This is cis isomer. Yes, or you can say cis platin. You would have heard this is platin used as a drug in the treatment of cancer. So this is what we call cis platin, or you can say its name is cis, and of course diamine, cis diamine, dichloride, cis diamine, yes, D-I-A-M-M-I-N-E, cis diamine, dichloride, yes. Platinum, yes, it is 2. Oxidation number of platinum here is 2 there. Platinum 2, this is what we call it as cis isomer. And it's a trans isomer is, look at this. You just change the positions of the ligands here. You just change the positions of the ligand here. Yes, here it is NH3 there. Yes, and of course here it is NH3. And just observe, you should connect ligands to the central metal atom through donor atoms. Here it is a chloro, here it is a chloride, and of course it will be, yes it is trans isomer, trans diamine dichloride platinum 2, that is trans diamine, yes, dichloride, yes, platinum 2. This is what we call it as geometrical isomerism in, yes it is, diamine dichloro platinum 2 complex, yes. Sir, it is there in your NCERT book. That's why you may expect question right. Geometrical isomers of this complex. Andaga, you will do it. This is the trans and the trans. So, this is what we call it as geometrical isomerism in square planar complexes. Apart from that, you know, let us see geometrical isomerism in complexes with coordination number 6. Yes, let us see. Geometrical isomerism in complexes with coordination number 6 here. Okay, now we'll see that. Yes, let us see. Geometrical isomerism in complexes with coordination number 6. You know that if the coordination number of acetates central metal ion is 6, definitely it will form acetates octahedral complex, right? Definitely that will form octahedral complex. This is what we call it as the arrangement of coordinate bonds around the central metal atom. Yes, arrangement of coordinate bonds around the central metal atom. Yes, and this is what we call it as. And among, out of these 6 bonds, 4 bonds are present in one plane. One bond is above the plane, another bond is below the plane. Yes, this is what we call it as geometric isomerism, that is isomerism. And look at this, you know. And this particular arrangement is characterized by, yes, it is 4 faces above the plane and 4 faces below the plane. Therefore, that's why it is called as octahedral complex. Now then, and of course, as far as octahedral complexes are concerned, you are supposed to study geometrical isomerism in the case of complexes of the type MX4L2. M is a central metal atom or ion, X is a monodentate ligand, L is a monodentate ligand. This is 2 different ligands are there. Now then, X is, there are 4 molecules of X, 2 molecules of L. For example, if I say this is position number 1, this is position number 2, this is position number 3, this is position number 4, this is 5, and it is 6 on the equator. Yes. And as far as octahedral complexes are concerned, in the case of octahedral complexes, if 2 similar ligands are at the 1-2 positions, if 2 similar ligands are at the 1-2 positions or 1-3 positions, yes, 1-3 positions. If 2 similar ligands are at the 1-2 position or 1-3 position or 1-4 positions, 1-4 positions or 1-5 positions. So, if 2 similar ligands are at the 1-2 or 1-3 or 1-4 or 1-5, then those isomers are called as cis isomers. If 2 similar ligands are at the either 1-2 or 1-3 or 1-4 or 1-5 positions, they are all coming under cis isomers. If 2 similar ligands are at the 1-6 position, that is 1-6 position, 2-4 position, yes, 2-4 position, 3-5 position, and that is they form, yes, it is trans isomers. In the case of trans isomers, 2 similar groups are at the 1-6 or 5-3 or 2-4, and of course that is trans isomers. And you should take this as a reference for writing geometrical isomers of different complexes. Okay, now? And of course, I have prepared one separate video in order to convince the geometrical isomers of different complexes, right? Where I am using some models in order to demonstrate the geometrical isomerism in complexes. After this class, you know, you can observe this, you can watch that video where it will be clearly explained that how exactly I can justify 1-2, 1-3, 1-4 and 1-5 positions are cis isomers. Neatagi nanu aa ondu demonstration alli convince maadidini. Okay, na ee ishte tilkoli. If 2 similar groups are at the 1-2 or 1-3 or 1-5 or 1-5 positions, They are all cis isomers. Whereas if I say, you know, two similar groups at the 1-6 positions, it means that, you know, two similar groups occupy the positions which are opposite to each other. Oh, that 3-5 opposite to each other. Yes, it is 2-4 opposite to each other. 1-6 opposite to each other. Like that, you know, 1-2, 1-3, 1-4, and 1-5 positions. In these positions, two similar groups occupy the positions which are adjacent to each other. Therefore, they are cis isomers. Okay, now. And of course, as far as your NCERT textbook is concerned, you are supposed to write, yes it is, geometrical isomers. You are supposed to write geometrical isomers of different complexes. For example, that is CO, NS3 four times, and it is Cl2. This is, and of course it is plus, this is one complex. Tetramine, dichloride, cobalt 3 ion. This is one complex. And I am supposed to write, you know, you are supposed to write, you know, geometrical isomers of this complex. This is octahedral complex. Know that? This is octahedral complex with a coordination number. Yes, it is 6 here. With respect to this complex, you know, cobalt is at the center. Now the central metal atom is cobalt. Know that? And of course, here we have, yes, it is one bond. Here we have another bond. Here it is one more bond. Yes, it is 6 bonds are arranged in this fashion. Know that? Know that? Say, for example, two chloro groups are here, yes. Two chloro groups are occupying 1-2 positions. Remaining, this is ammonia, yes. This is ammonia. Gamanisbeku, while connecting ammonia molecules to cobalt, it should be connected through donor atom. Look at this, NH3, how the? Here it is, NH3, how the? Itharane baribeku, yes. N anna, you cobalt, you connect maadabeku. Ammonia should be attached to the cobalt through nitrogen, yes. This is what we call it as one complex, and of course, the total charge of this complex is plus. Look at this. Your oxidation number of cobalt is plus 3, minus 1 into 2, minus 2, plus 3, minus 6, plus 1. Agata. This is charge of the complex. Adu kuda baribek. Yes. And of course, I just call it as this is cis isomer. This is cis isomer. And as far as its trans isomer is concerned, I can write trans isomer of that particular complex also. Look at this. This is what we call it as 6 coordinate bonds. And as I said, if I write two similar groups at 1-6 positions, which are opposite to each other, is it not? That is, here it is Cl. Here it is Cl, 1-6 position. If two chloro groups are at the 1-6 positions, they are occupying the positions which are opposite to each other. So this is what NH3 there. This is what NH3, yes. And of course, this is NH3, yes. This is also NH3. This is what we call it as, yes, it is. And of course, plus there, yes. This is what we call it as, the trans isomer. This is what we call it as, this is trans isomer. And of course, this is what we call it as, the geometrical isomers of the complex CO, NH3 four times, Cl2 there, yes. So, this is what we call it as geometrical isomerism in this complex. Now, at this moment, we'll go to the one more, yes, it is example where you are supposed to write geometrical isomers of one more complex, yes. We'll see that, yes. That will be, yes, it is one more octahedral complex where you will find central metal ion is attached to the bidentate ligand, that is COEN twice, and of course it will be, yes, it is Cl2. This is one more complex where two ethylene diamine molecules are attached to the cobalt there. Let me remind you that ethylene diamine is a bidentate ligand. How the? It is characterized by, yes, it is two donor atoms. How the? It is characterized by two donor atoms. How the? While writing the structure of this particular complex, geometrical isomers of this complex, look at this, no charges over the coordination sphere. Coordination sphere doesn't have any charge here. CO is in plus 2 state, Cl2 is in, yes it is, minus 2, plus 2, minus 2 cancel, like 0 agata. This is what we call, yes it is, as far as IUPAC name of this complex is concerned, it is bis ethane 1,2 diamine dichloride cobalt 2, yes. So this is what we call it as. And as far as the geometrical isomers are concerned, so just first you write, yes it is, you just observe how to write the geometric isomers. Ee tara neevu first two coordinate bonds anna arrange maadkonbidi, yes. And here it is chloro, and here it is chloro there, yes. two chloro groups are T, one, two positions. So the your one ethylene diamine is characterized by, yes, it is two nitrogen atoms. So the this is one nitrogen atom, this is another atom, this is what we call it as CH2, single bond CH2, and of course H2, and of course H2. It very well. One ethylene diamine molecule can form two bonds, alva. One ethylene diamine molecule can form two bonds. So then, hagagi, I can write, yes, it is the structure of this particular group is like this. Or you can say, you can avoid this writing, yes, it is this complete structure, and you can write, instead of writing the complete structure of the molecule, simply you just show me the donor atoms here. These two donor atoms are from one molecule of ethylene diamine, and that is En. That is En is attached to cobalt through these two donor atoms. This is how you can write the acidic structure. And this is one ethylene diamine. We have two ethylene diamine. That can also be written like this. Two nitrogen atoms. And of course, this is En. And this is what we call, this is what we call the complex here. Yes, look at this complex. This complex doesn't have any charges. How the two chloro groups occupy the positions which are adjacent to each other. Therefore, it is what we call it as cis isomer. Yes, this is what we call it as cis isomer. How the yes, this is what we call structure of this particular complex. And it's a trans isomer, can be written like this. Look at this. Yes. First new octahedral complexes bonds in either arrange markomedi. Two chloro groups, they are adjacent to each other, but here in trans isomer, two chloro groups are the opposite to each other. How the yad chloro groups are only one ethylene diamine will form two coordinate bonds. This is one ethylene diamine. Another ethylene diamine also form, yes, it is two coordinate bonds. How the this is one ethylene diamine, this is another ethylene diamine, and of course, two chloro groups are opposite to each other. Two chloro groups are the opposite to each other. How the therefore it is trans isomer. Yes, this is what we call it as trans isomer. This is what we call it as cis and trans isomers of this particular complex. Apart from that, you know, as per your NCERT textbook, you are supposed to study, you are supposed to write the structures of, yes, it is the octahedral complexes of the type MA3L3. So far, you know, we studied complexes of the type A2L4, how the MA2L4 study one, how the. And one more complex we studied, MA2, and of course L single bond L5. This is bidentate ligand, monodentate ligand. Your, yes, it is all the six ligands are monodentate. We studied both the complexes. Now let us see MA3L3. Geometrical isomerism in MA3L3. That is, as an example for that, you know, you are supposed to study CO NS3 three times, A3I2. L3 is NO2 three times. This is what we call MA3L3 type complex. That is triamine, trinitrito-N, cobalt 3. This is what we call name of this complex. I am supposed to write geometrical isomers for this. I already said, in the case of octahedral complexes, you know, you must write, yes it is arrangement of, yes it is bonds here. How the? Look for it. Three ammonia molecules can be written like this. How the? This is three ammonia molecules. And of course, three nitro groups can be written like this. This is one possible arrangement. Two similar groups are the 1-3, 1-2 positions. Two similar groups are the 1-2 positions. Therefore, I can call it as cis isomer, or you can say, and especially in the case of MA3L3 type, this isomer is called as fat isomer, or you can say facial isomer. We call it as, this is what we call it as facial isomer. Why this is called as facial isomer? In the case of this complex, if three similar groups are present at this particular position, look at this. When these groups are at this particular position, you know, they are occupying the corners of one of the faces of the octahedra. This is one of the faces of the octahedra. If I write three similar groups at this position, they are at the corners of one of the faces of the regular octahedra. That's why it is called as facial. Look at this. This is one more face. Yes. This is one more face. Look at this. Three similar groups are occupying three corners of one of the faces, because octahedra is characterized by eight faces. Out of eight faces, you know, if ligands are arranged in this fashion, these three ligands are occupying three corners of one of the faces of the octahedra, and that's why it is what we call it as facial. Yes, it is isomer anta karithivi. This is what we call it as facial isomer anta karithivi. Yes, so this is what we call facial isomer. Yes, and its trans isomer can be written like this. Look at this. This is cobalt. Yes, this first you write. Yes, it is the bonds like this. First bonds in a berkumbi. Yes, and what I will do here, I placed three similar groups at this position. Now I am going to change that position. This is NS3, right? And this is NS3, right? And I am going to change the position. Instead of that, now I am going to write here. This is NS3, right? So also, remaining three positions will be occupied by NO2. This is NO2, and it will be NO2. Yes. And this is what we call it as Mohr isomer. We call it as. This is called as Mohr isomer, or you can say meridional isomer. This is meridional isomer. Why it is meridional isomer? Because if three similar ligands are these positions, if I arrange these three similar ligands in this fashion, these three similar ligands are occupying meridian of the octahedron, right? They are occupying meridian, one of the meridians of, yes, it is octahedron, and that I have shown in the demonstration in the separate video that you are going to observe after this class. Okay, na? ಒಂದು ಸಪರೇಟ್ ವಿಡಿಯೋ ಮಾಡಿದೀನಿ ಇದೆಲ್ಲ ಕನ್ವಿನ್ಸ್ ಮಾಡ್ಲಿಕ್ಕೆ ನಿಮಗೆ ಒಂದು ಮಾಡೆಲ್ ಎಲ್ಲ ತಗೊಂಡ್ಬಿಟ್ಟು ಓಕೆನಾ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ನಿಮಗೆ ಇನ್ನೂ ಕ್ಲಾರಿಟಿ ಸಿಗುತ್ತೆ ಸೊ ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ಇಫ್ ತ್ರೀ ಸಿಮಿಲರ್ ಗ್ರೂಪ್ಸ್ ಆಟ್ ದಿಸ್ ಪೊಸಿಷನ್ಸ್ ನೋ ದೇ ಆರ್ ಸೆಟ್ ಟು ಬಿ ಆಕ್ಯುಪೈಂಗ್ ಎಸ್ ಇಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಮೆರಿಡಿಯೋನಲ್ ಮೆರಿಡಿಯೋನ್ ಅಂತಂದ್ರೆ ಮೆರಿಡಿಯೋನ್ ಅಂತಂದ್ರೆ ಏನು ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ಒನ್ ಇಮ್ಯಾಜಿನರಿ ಲೈನ್ ಪಾಸಿಂಗ್ ಥ್ರೂ ದಿ ಅಪೆಕ್ಸಸ್ ಆಫ್ ದಿ ಎಸ್ ಇಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಆಕ್ಟಾಹೆಡ್ರನ್ ಲುಕ್ ಅಟ್ ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ಒನ್ ಇಮ್ಯಾಜಿನರಿ ಲೈನ್ ಪಾಸಿಂಗ್ ಥ್ರೂ ದಿ ಅಪೆಕ್ಸ್ ದಿಸ್ ಟು ಆರ್ ದಿ apices of the octahedra, and of course these similar ligands are occupying, yes it is, apices of, one of the apices of, yes it is, octahedron. That's why it is meridional there. Yes, so that's why it is what we call it as meridional. Okay, na? So this is what we call, yes it is meridional. Yes, look at this. Yes it is. Yes. Like this, I can show. This is occupying. They are along the meridian of. Yes, it is. Yes, it is. What we call it as the regular octahedron, and this is what we call meridional type. Agbodala. Yes. So this is what we call it as Mohr, and yes, it is fat isomers. Example kehte right. Yes, it is fat and Mohr isomers of this complex. Okay, na? Then you are supposed to write it. Yes. And of course, this particular complex doesn't have any charges. Illa adu charges illa. Yakandre oxidation number of cobalt is 3+. That will be balanced by 3 nitro groups. Adu -3 + 3 cancel agutte. Hagagi that doesn't have any charges. And this is what we call it as geometric isomerism in the complexes of the type MA3, L3. And of course, neevu exam alli ee tara structures na bariyodannu kalibeku. Okay, na? Nan hege start madidu hage bariri. Yen tondre illa. Hauda? ಬಟ್ ಇದು ನಿಮ್ಗೆ ಇನ್ನೂ ಕ್ಲಾರಿಟಿ ತ್ರೀ ಡೈಮೆನ್ಷನಲ್ ಅರೇಂಜ್ಮೆಂಟ್ ಹೇಗೆ ಇದೆ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳ್ಬಿಟ್ಟು ನಿಮಗೆ ಕ್ಲಾರಿಟಿ ಸಿಗ್ಬೇಕಂದ್ರೆ ಇದಕ್ಕೋಸ್ಕರ ಒಂದು ಸಪರೇಟ್ ವಿಡಿಯೋ ಮಾಡಿದೀನಿ ಜಿಯೋಮೆಟ್ರಿಕಲ್ ಐಸೋಮೆರಿಸಮ್ಗೋಸ್ಕರ. ಅದನ್ನ ಈ ಕ್ಲಾಸ್ ಆದ ತಕ್ಷಣ ನೀವು ಬೇಕಾದ್ರೆ ನೋಡ್ಬೋದು. ಆಗ್ಬೋದಲ್ಲ, ತಿಳಿಸಿದೆ. ಎಸ್, ಲೆಟ್ ಮೀ ಎಕ್ಸ್ಪ್ಲೈನ್ ದ ಜಿಯೋಮೆಟ್ರಿಕಲ್ ಐಸೋಮೆರಿಸಮ್ ಇನ್ ಕಾಂಪ್ಲೆಕ್ಸಸ್, ರೈಟ್? ಯು ನೋ ಇನ್ ದ ಕಾಂಪ್ಲೆಕ್ಸಸ್ ನೋ ವಿ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಸಿಸ್ ಐಸೋಮೆರಿಸಮ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಟ್ರಾನ್ಸ್ ಐಸೋಮೆರಿಸಮ್. ಹಿಯರ್ ವಿ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಒನ್ ಕಾಂಪ್ಲೆಕ್ಸ್. ಲುಕ್ ಅಟ್ ದಿಸ್, ದ ಸೆಂಟ್ರಲ್ ಆಟಮ್, ಓಕೆನಾ, attached to four ligands, right? All the four ligands are, yes, monodentate ligands. Here we have, you will find two green spheres here. Here also we have two, you know, that metallic spheres, right? Okay, na? Okay, na? Here just observe this central metal ion. All the ligands are present in one plane because it's a square planar complex. Look at here, two similar ligands are there. They are on the same side. Two similar ligands are on the same side. Therefore, it is cis. this is called as cis form, is it not? Ether itkoli. Okay na, central metal atom. Okay na, ill nodi erdu similar atoms onde kade ide. Okay na, grey colored spheres agli, green colored spheres agli, they are ligands. Avda ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಎರಡು ಸಿಮಿಲರ್ ಲಿಗ್ಯಾಂಡ್ಸ್ ಇದೆ, ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಎರಡು ಸಿಮಿಲರ್ ಲಿಗ್ಯಾಂಡ್ಸ್ ಇದೆ, ದೇ ಆರ್ ಆನ್ ದ ಸೇಮ್ ಸೈಡ್, ದೇರ್ ಫೋರ್ ದಟ್ ಇಸ್ ವಾಟ್ ವಿ ಕಾಲ್ ಇಟ್ ಅಸ್ ಸಿಸ್ ಐಸೋಮರಿಸಮ್. ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ಸಿಸ್ ಐಸೋಮರ್. ಓಕೆ, ಇಫ್ ಐ ಚೇಂಜ್ ದಿ ಪೊಸಿಷನ್ ಆಫ್ ಲಿಗ್ಯಾಂಡ್ಸ್, ಲುಕ್ ಅಟ್ ದಿಸ್. ಇಫ್ ಐ ಚೇಂಜ್ ದಿ ಪೊಸಿಷನ್ ಆಫ್ ಲಿಗ್ಯಾಂಡ್ಸ್, ಓಕೆ, ವಾಟ್ ಹ್ಯಾಪನ್ಸ್, ಲುಕ್ ಯೋರ್. ಇಫ್ ಐ ಚೇಂಜ್ ದ ಪೊಸಿಷನ್ ಆಫ್ ಲಿಗ್ಯಾಂಡ್ಸ್, ಲುಕ್ ಯೋರ್, ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ಹೌ ವಾಟ್ ವಿ ಕಾಲ್ ಇಟ್ ಅಸ್ ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ಟ್ರಾನ್ಸ್ ಐಸೋಮರಿಸಮ್, ಇಸ್ ಇಟ್ ನಾಟ್? ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ವಾಟ್ ವಿ ಕಾಲ್ ಇಟ್ ಅಸ್ ಟ್ರಾನ್ಸ್ ಐಸೋಮರಿಸಮ್, ಬಿಕಾಸ್ ಟೂ ಸಿಮಿಲರ್ ಲಿಗ್ಯಾಂಡ್ಸ್ ದೇ ಆರ್ ಇನ್ ದಿ ಆಪೋಸಿಟ್ ಸೈಡ್, ಆಪೋಸಿಟ್ ಡೈರೆಕ್ಷನ್. Two green spheres are in the opposite direction. This is what? Trans isomer. Okay, na? Earlier was cis isomer. Okay, na? So this is geometrical isomerism. Yes, it is the square planar complexes with coordination number 4. Yes. Now we'll go for the geometrical isomerism. Geometrical isomerism in octahedral complexes, right? In the case of octahedral complexes, you know, there are, you know, that 6 monodentatic ends, atwa 6 coordinate bonds, you know, around the central metal ion. This is what we call it as the octahedral complex, right? Look at this. This is octahedral complex, right? Look at this. Four ligands are on the same, four ligands are in one plane. One is above the plane, another is below the plane. Total is 6 ligands. This is what we call it as octahedral complex. Why it is octahedral complex? Now that coordination number 6 is there. Nalakku coordinate bonds to one plane there. ಒಂದು ಬಾಂಡ್ ಎಬೋ ದ ಪ್ಲೇನ್ ಇದೆ, ಇನ್ನೊಂದು ಬಾಂಡ್ ಬಿಲೋ ದ ಪ್ಲೇನ್ ಇದೆ, ಹೌದಾ? ಓಕೆ, ನಾ ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ಆಕ್ಟೈಡಲ್. ವೈ ಇಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಆಕ್ಟೈಡಲ್? ಬಿಕಾಸ್ ಲುಕ್ ಹಿಯರ್, ಇನ್ ದಿಸ್ ಕೇಸ್ ಏನೋ ಇದು ಪ್ಲೇನ್ ಅಂತ ಇಟ್ಕೊಂಡ್ರೆ ಎಬೋ ದ ಪ್ಲೇನ್, ಲುಕ್ ಇಟ್ ದಿಸ್, ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ಒನ್ ಫೇಸ್, ಟೂ ಫೇಸ್, ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ತ್ರೀ ಫೇಸ್, ಥರ್ಡ್ ಫೇಸ್, ಅಂಡ್ ಇಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಫೋರ್ ಫೇಸ್. ಎಬೋ ದ ಪ್ಲೇನ್ ದೇರ್ ಆರ್ ಫೋರ್ ಫೇಸಸ್, ಬಿಲೋ ದ ಪ್ಲೇನ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ ದೇರ್ ಆರ್ ಫೋರ್ ಫೇಸಸ್. ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಒಂದು ಫೇಸ್, ಒಂದು ಫೇಸ್ ಇದೆ, ಇಲ್ಲೊಂದು ಫೇಸ್ ಇದೆ, ಓಕೆನಾ? ಮತ್ತೊಂದು ಫೇಸ್ ಇದೆ ಇಲ್ಲಿ, ರೈಟ್? ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ one more phase and it is one more phase. Totally above the plane 4 phases, below the plane 4 phases, therefore it is octahedra. There are 8 phases. And of course in this particular model, you know, look at this, this is a complex of the type, this is a complex of the type that is m, right? M is a central metal atom. Yes, okay, na? This is central metal atom and it is l2 and it is x4. L is a monodentate ligand, X is also monodentate ligand. Totally 6 ligands. Out of 6, you know, 2 are similar ligand, L2. Remaining 4 are similar. That is X4. They are attached to the central metal atom 4, M. Your M is at the central metal atom. Yes. Okay, na? You know, 4 ligands there. 4 green spheres there. 2 grey spheres there. Okay? So, what kind of, yes, it is isomerities. Look at this. Two similar ligands are on the same side. Okay? ಹೌದಲ್ವೋ? ದೇರ್ ಫಾರ್ ಇಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಸಿಸ್ ಐಸೋಮರ್. ಇದನ್ನ ನೋಡಿ, ಈ ತರ ನೋಡಕ್ಕೆ ನೋಡಬಹುದು, ಇದು ಸಿಸ್ ಐಸೋಮರ್, ಹೌದಾ? ಇದನ್ನ ಈ ತರ ನೋಡಿ ಬೇಕಾದ್ರೆ, ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ವಾಟ್ ವಿ ಕಾಲ್ ಇಟ್ ಇಸ್ ವೆನ್ ಟೂ ಸಿಮಿಲರ್ ಲಿಗ್ಯಾಂಡ್ಸ್ ಆರ್ ದಿ 1-2 ಪೊಸಿಷನ್. ಇದು 1-2 ಪೊಸಿಷನ್ ಅಂತ ತಗೊಂಡ್ರೆ ಇದು ಕೂಡ ಏನಾಗುತ್ತೆ? ದಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಸಿಸ್ ಐಸೋಮರ್. ಎಸ್, ಹೌದಲ್ವೋ? ಇದೇ 1-2. ಯಾಕೆ ಇದನ್ನೇ ನಾವು ಸಿಸ್ ಅಂತ ತಗೋತೀವಿ ಅಂದ್ರೆ, ಇದೇ ಮಾಲಿಕ್ಯುಲ್ ಅನ್ನ ನಾವು ಈ ತರ ನೋಡಿದ್ರೆ ನೋಡಿ, ಇವೆರಡು ಇದೊಂದು ಬಾಂಡ್, ಇದೊಂದು ಬಾಂಡ್ ಮೇಲೆ ಕೆಳಗೆ ಇಲ್ಲ ಅಂತ ಅನ್ಕೊಂಡ್ರೆ ನೋಡಿ ಏನಾಯ್ತು? Two similar ligands are on the same side, therefore it is cis isomer. Avadalva? So this is what we call it as cis isomer anta aitu, right? You know, if you go for the trans isomer beko andre, change the position of the ligands, right? Change the position of ligands, right? Ligand position anna change maadi. This is, look at this, ega ligand position change maadi takshane, yes, look at this, ligand position change maadi anna. Ega naitu, all four green spheres are on the one plane, grey spheres above the plane and below the plane, and of course they are in the opposite direction, therefore it is what we call it as trans isomer. This is what we call it as trans isomer. Yes, so this is what we call it as trans isomer.
Idu first position, idu second position, idu sixth position. 1/6 position enagutte? Trans agutte.
Adhe tara now square plane bonds no above and below the plane. Look at this, nimage gothagutalva? Two green spheres on the opposite sides, two grey spheres on the opposite side. This is what we call it as trans. Adhe tara this is what we call it as trans isomer. Yes, okay, na? Apart from that, you know, we have a complexes of the type that is ML3X3 anta ide, and there are three similar type of L and three similar type of X. This is ML3X3, and in the case of ML3X3, look at this, this is one complex that is what we call it as ML3X3 anta. Yakani central metallatin is attached to three green spheres and three gray spheres. So this also constitutes what we call it as yes, it is geometrical isomerism. Two similar spheres on the opposite sides. Therefore, it is transenthalpy. ML3X3 case alli, this is called as meridional anta karithivi na. Enanta karithivi? Meridional isomer athwa mer isomer anta karithivi. Yakandre, look at the two similar groups, you know, they are at the apexes of the, yes it is, they are at the opposite apexes. You know, that is, this is a straight line passing through meridian. This is meridian. Meridian andre eno? It's a straight line passing through two apexes, two opposite apexes, right? Idu one apex, idu one apex, and straight line passing through it. That is what we call it as meridian. Look at this, all the, yes it is, similar groups. Look at this, all the similar groups, you know, they are in the three similar groups. Ella gray spheres in the, they are along the meridian. How the? This is, they are along the meridian. Therefore, it is mer isomer. Inna nodi. Inna more similar ligands in the nodi. Like, look at this. Look at this. Yes. How the alva? This is what we call it as Ivukuda along the meridian. How the? Therefore, yes it is, this is called as mer isomer. This is called as meridional isomer anta karithivi. Yes. Okay na? Yes. Innondu idu nodi. What is that? This is trans type antanu karibodu. Illa andre meridional anta karithivi. That is trans isomer of ML3X3 is called as meridional. What about cis isomer? Remember the cis isomer. 1-2 positions are similar ligands. This is what we call it as position change madiga. Positions are change madtiniga. Yes. Look here. So this is, yes it is. 1-2 positions are two similar ligands. 1-2 positions are two similar ligands. So this is what we call it as cis isomer. Adhe ML3X3 type alli. Idu enantu karithivi? Facial type anta karithivi. Yakandre? Look at this. Three similar ligands are at the face. It is one of the faces. Nodi, adu bekare easy identify maadabodu. Look at this. This will form, these three will form. Yes, these three similar ligands. These three similar ligands. They are at the apexes of the one of the faces. Avtane, this is one face. They will form, all the three are present in one face. Avtane, therefore, this is facial type. Yes, athwa idu nodi bekare. All the three are present at the one face. Avtane, this is also, all the three are present at the one face.
This is what we call it as facial type.
Okay, na? This is not it. This is not it. Correct. Look at this. This is face. Three ligands. This is what we call it as. Yes, it is facial type. Yes, that is. This is what we call it as. These three will form one face. These three will form another face. This is what we call it as facial type. Okay, na? So, right? So, this is what we call it as. It's a demonstration of geometrical isomers of square planar complexes and octahedral complexes. Arthaayithu ankothini. Yes. Agbodha? Thank you. So, agadre, ellaru adanna demonstration nodidre anta ankothini. Arthaagide nimge ankothini. Yes. The separate video nodidralla iga. I think idella correct aagi nimge convince aagide anta bhavisthini. Okay na? In the next video, we'll see stereoisomerism and also bonding in coordination compounds. The next video is of course very important as far as your annual examination is concerned, where we are going to discuss the important theories which will be used to explain the bonding in coordination compounds. That is Werner's theory of coordination compounds, or Werner's theory of complexes, and Wellens bond theory of, yes it is, complexes. That we'll see in the next video. Akbuda, thank you, right?